Okay.
Dire team ban. Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. Dire team ban. Radiant team pick.
Chen.
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Zeus. Witch Doctor.
Radiant team pick.
Vengeful spirit.
Radiant team ban.
All right. Hello, and welcome back, everybody. We're into game number two. Yes, I was enjoying a little bit of a peanut butter sandwich there. It was quite delicious. And I'll let you guys watch the start of the draft here, but it's going to be game two of Team Spirit, HellRaisers. I am not alone. I am Mopex. I am joined by Scant. Scant, are you there?
Like a bit of a one-way traffic situation, right? HellRaisers weren't really in it ever.
Yeah, it was kind of... At the very start, they got like a quick couple of towers. Much like what you would expect with that kind of a strategy, so... I have a follow-up to, I just was, you know, upstairs in my kitchen grabbing some food finally, and I was talking to one of the guys working there. So do you know why we had a shop back that whole time? It turns out, under my sink in the house I purchased, there was some cardboard on the wall. And that, in like, the outside, basically under the sink, it wasn't fully sealed off in the concrete because of some work they'd been doing on the plumbing, and they didn't redo it with, like, concrete or wood or anything like that. It was just a cardboard cover, which was fine, I guess. But then they blew in the insulation from the outside, and it was all over my kitchen. Apparently, it was pretty hilarious.
But, see.
That was the issue. So now you know. Now, and I know you guys were, like, gonna go to bed wondering what the hell happened. Well, don't worry, I got you covered. So now we can talk about Dota, because it wouldn't be appropriate for a Dota draft if we didn't start it once there were already 8 heroes in the draft talked about. So, what are you thinking so far?
I mean, because I didn't get to speak at the start of the series, one thing I want to say, I think Spirit come into this qualifier as, like, already favorites for top two.
Agreed.
I think Spirit alongside Liquid, I guess. And HellRaisers are, like, to me, very clearly the weakest team in the qualifier. Like, they just haven't been on good form for, like, 6 months, basically. So that's what I was looking at a bit of the game, and I looked at the end of the game screen, and I was like, it's not really that surprising to me. The thing I want to ask you about last game is the OD. If you think that, like, was that a significant part of the success that Spirit had? Or was it just like, oh, they had an OD? Because often I've seen in this patch, I've seen quite a few times, teams win with OD, but it's not necessarily because of the OD in any way.
I'd probably just have to agree with you on that one, actually, because they picked up the OD and then HellRaisers actually picked the Pugnet after. I mean, not surprising, you're thinking, like, oh, it's going to be a counter, and it looks like they probably had some sort of a strat in mind anyway with the Pugnet. Because, you know, Tombstone, Pugnet, not the newest thing around the block, but It did help in terms of dominating the mid lane. Like, Alpha Ninja got shut down pretty hard. Got killed once or twice. Just stealing all of his intelligence made it pretty easy. But, I don't know. I know what you mean. Like, he was good. It's not something other heroes couldn't have done.
Because, I mean, the main role of the hero at the moment is just to, like, deal lots of damage, right?
That's pretty much it.
And there's a lot of heroes that could do that, so... I guess it's like certain kind of damage dealing, and look at that, Goblack's gonna be playing as Tree and Protector again. Was it you I was casting with earlier? I don't think so. Okay, so I'll tell you what he did, because this is great. Goblack bought very early and Talon, and he jungled, and he punished creeps, and he had a fast axe. Like, he was just standing around healing his allies while he punched creeps with the Iron Talon. And he had a 20-minute Aghanim Scepter on, like, a 4-position tree. Remaining.
What?
Yep. Just Iron Talon finally finding the value remaining. In the hands of the Tree and Protector. I mean, he literally, like... I think he, like, uses the activates more than he hits the creep twice and it's dead.
I mean, there was that game in Dota Pit, like, 2 seasons ago. It was in... I think it was Season 3, where there was the Position 1 tree and it had, a 14-minute Aghanim Scepter or something like that. That was some clowny stuff. I don't recall if that was Goblack actually playing in the safe lane as well then, but... I'd say we're gonna get that clockwork. Oh, great. We need to try and deal with this again.
Spirits are really liking... Like, Goblack seems to like to draft heroes that are, like, annoyingly difficult to kill. It actually kind of makes sense, especially in the context of this qualifier, where, like, there's a lot of CIS feel to it. I mean, there's a lot of CIS teams, and very often, even the more developed CIS teams that are, like, not playing the stereotypical CIS style, that are more careful, still get punished sometimes for overaggression. And you've got Sven with Warcry, you've got Witch Doctor's Casks and Heal, you've got the Treant here.
Mm-hmm.
They've been liking the Sven a lot, in particular. Obviously very good against the Venge and the Dazzle. It's, like, almost necessary, I feel. In fact, I think if you look at the way these drafts match up, if Spirit don't have that Sven, if it's any other hero, I feel like they're behind in the draft. So... Works out in their favor. I think they have it. Definitely balances things out a lot more nicely.
Well, they'll give themselves a final opportunity here. I like that Broodman. It's pretty scary. Can we just get, like, an offlane Weaver and just call this, like, I don't even know what patch this would be. 6.778? Is that Treant Weaver? I was talking about this last match because we had an OD picked up, and then I wanted to talk about Treant OD because they had Nevadin.
I see.
You remember those days, though. Diving towers. Yeah. That was some fun
but
stuff.
But it's the most overpowered hero in the game. Enchantress.
Apparently.
Nobody can beat this hero.
She sneaks through thanks to Invoker being a real champ and taking that title.
I don't know what to do against Enchantress. This is like a... If I was drafting and they pick Enchantress, I'd be like, guess we need, like, spell
like Nyx?
Burst damage.
I don't even know.
You know, yeah. 5 seconds.
Like Actually, you can't even do it with Nyx either. Yeah.
Yeah, it's really just, like, a very annoying hero to have to deal with. And the whole part, like, it plays from the offlane, but, like, almost necessarily will scale.
Yeah.
Because you're just not going to be able to control it. So, from the start of the game, you're, like, the enemy team has inevitability. And this game especially, Goblack's going to be farming a jungle with his tree. They're going to get value in the offlane, the mid lane, and the safe lane. They're just going to get farming freaking everyone. So, I think the play for HellRaisers is, yeah, okay, drawing it. Like, the play is all in push, which is kind of what they did last game, right?
Like, huh, yeah.
All in push, hope it works. But
I guess once you have the Chen, you're a little bit committed. Not necessarily committed to it completely, like, reading average time of how it does definitely scale way better into late game now with Chen, but I feel, I don't know.
It's mid-draw, right? And safe lane bench.
Yeah. Oh. How do you kill this Enchantress still? Like, I still don't see how you kill her. Because you just drafted a Drow Ranger.
Yeah, I mean, that's... Like, the plan is not to... They're not thinking about that. They're not even thinking about how to kill heroes. They're like,
no.
We're going to assemble and kill buildings, and they won't be able to deal with us. Or like, if they force us to fight them, we'll be all there together with Venge Aura and Drow Aura, and then people will die to, like, one or two shots. But it's so much, like, it's very, very all-in. It's a very all-in mentality, and Spirits have, like, they could push, they could sit back and farm. They got a lot of good ways to get value on, like, all of their heroes from early on. Look at that, Goblack, starting with the Iron Talon. Straight at it.
This is awesome.
He's just, we should just keep the camera on him as he punches creeps. Follow his progress in the jungle.
It's almost going to be as good as that battle in the Roshan pit.
Oh, yeah.
We had a couple creeps duking it out. That was fun. Well, there's no Shadow Fiend. Actually, who banned out the Shadow Fiend? Was that Team Spirit? Because they didn't want the Clockwork Shadow Fiend thing? They did too, didn't they?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
30 seconds.
I wonder if they would have went for that. Probably.
Yeah, I think you do. I think it makes both the Clock and the Shadow Fiend much stronger picks when you can do that abuse. And both of them are substantially weaker picks when you can't.
Yeah. Well, this will be my first Drow game that I've cast, I want to say, in extreme. I don't even know the last time I saw a Drow.
You don't watch enough that I was doing. Southeast SEA, Asian Dota, yes.
Oh, nice. Shoshlo, he got it. Nice plays. That was well done.
I think HR have lost both their matches before this one. This is their third match of the qualifier.
Fourth. Or do you mean... Yeah, they played two games versus Empire. This will be their fourth.
Oh, okay. So they lost 2-0 against Empire, and this is only their second opponent. Okay.
Right.
I see. But yeah, I don't know. I can't shake the feeling that this is like... This team has been in decline ever since DAC, like start of last year, and... I don't know why, because they look
like
so
the
hard
Red Bull Battlegrounds kind of thing, like way back when.
Yeah.
Just after DAC, I suppose. I don't know, like, what happened to DAC? They just looked so strong.
Yeah.
Coming into it, everyone was like HR and, you know.
That's CIS curse. There's a lot of CIS teams that historically have like had one tournament or one LAN or... Why it's so impressive, it seems like Vega Squad and Virtus Pro are like repeatedly doing well and... All the other CIS teams trying to be that next big, like, branded CIS team that everyone talks about. Spirits, I would say, are in pole position to be that team, though. Team is like... They even right off to the... Sorry, what are you laughing at?
No, I can't tell. Gobblack's leading the CIS chair. It's just so dumb. I'm sorry, continue, I didn't mean to interrupt. I'm just like, I'm just taking your advice and just leaving the camera here. that was rude of me, I'm sorry. Alright, Scant's left the cast, guys. It was lovely having him, but I can understand.
Sorry. While you're laughing, I muted myself and then I like forgot to unmute myself. That's...
Oh, you actually couldn't hear it? My whole explanation is why I was laughing?
I don't know, I heard. I just, okay. I wasn't speaking. That's, so what I wanted to say is, back when Spirit was still called CIS Rejects, like, after the International 5, that first, between the International and Frankfurt Majors, they were already, like, a pretty strong team. They were already, Goblock just suicides the neutrals, efficiency, whatever. I think they came second or third in one of the qualifiers, maybe the ESL or MLG or one of those. And then, like, after the Frankfurt Major, they, like, stepped it up even a further notch, they changed their name, and they won the MDL qualifier. And I think that if we talk for, like, the next big CIS team, even though there's so many in this qualifier, this is them, probably, although they just lost their career. They're gonna go for a kill on Ventral Spirit, though. The Tree Wars just fogging everywhere, and...
The Ward Wars, too, is... Oh, now we actually will miss the real first blood. I was in the top lanes. We're watching these guys duke it out bot, but looks like they will now throw the magic missiles, so it wasn't a total loss, guys, but the Warcry, it's just gonna be a zone out here.
How quick solo kill and charges? That's, I mean, it's just battery assault, right? Probably no right clicks.
He has 2 points? Yeah, he's got 2 points in the battery
assault. Probably, like, specifically didn't right click, because, you know, once you start right clicking, then you get out of range.
Yeah. He probably just got it. He must have just cogs during battery assault, the only way it happens. Because he should be able to run to the creeps and survive.
It's a start that HR need. Like we've said many times, they kind of need to just... This game needs to just go their way and keep going their way and never stop going their way. Because if it looks kind of even at any points, then a lot of trouble.
Well, he may have lost his bottle, but at least... Or rather, he may have lost his courier, but at least the bottle was on him. He was looking for the bottle crow as it was coming down from up there. And kind of sneaking out of the shop. And Goblack, I'm not sure what he's doing down here. He's just securing the rune, it would seem.
Oh, he's just taking it easy. I mean, he's...
Oh, no. Goddamn, will deny it.
I'm a bit surprised that draw rangers got so much more farm than Zeus. Do you know if did Chen have a creep here at the start in the mid lane?
I don't believe so. No, I haven't spotted one. Oh wait, there was a harpy. That was that in mid lane? I think there might have been a harpy in mid actually. Shots,
but yeah, maybe it's been some time mid. Don't explain it. But yeah, attempts on Witch Doctor, Goblack just heals. No problem at all. Now, Clockman's going forward. No, Shuffler wants to go for another kill attempt. Right, pulls back at the last second.
Is it still Blade Mail up against this team? Seems, yeah, that seems pretty good. It would be helpful when you're trying to escape from Enchantress too with their low HP pool, possibly.
Yeah, and there's not really... There's no especially big reason to buy Force. In fact, Force, you could argue, is like weak against Enchantress because it has potential to end up dealing more damage to your ally. Force them off.
Afterlife. Looks like he's gonna try and bait this out here.
I think he can, because Shockler's been like edging towards him every now and then, looking for... attempt. This is the lane swap, that's what this is, but they want to get a kill out of it.
Exactly. So the secret pioneered strategy, one might say. Definitely the one that I think is considered the most popular, as it were. They will get Iceberg. Hadouken, not quite enough damage though. Flare, last Hadouken.
Oh, clock
range.
Is so close to level
big.
6.
Not big though.
Clock was 6 though, it'd be a kill, but not quite there.
Oh, no more hiding up top. Ramsey will just take over, start moving into the creep waves.
Radiant's top tower.
And bottom lane, Thundershock's just chill next to a sentry ward. Rune Wars begin again. Iceberg actually not healing up yet, and now he's going in here. I almost able to get this kill. If that was any other rune, he would be dead, in fact.
Goblack hasn't... Goblack needs to...
going back in. At this creep. It's so slow though, and he's so fast. Now the enchantment come through. Oh, there's one more impetus. If you can get the damage and the range. Oh, goddamn, still too speedy.
Haste is gonna run out. He doesn't have a TP or anything, but it doesn't look like anyone from the Dire is actually intending to come down here. There's so many Radiant heroes. It's like they. Look, HellRaisers has got more kills, and they got more farm right at the start of the game. So the game is starting how they wanted to, but it's taking a lot of equipment. Speaking of
miscommunication. It works out in the end, I suppose. You think that was intentional, but it just looked really cool?
No, that was definitely miscommunication. I'm confident, I'll say.
That's a throwback, that's what we call that.
Yeah. Alright. I don't know, like at what point... I'm trying to figure out at what point, because things are going HellRaisers' way. But I don't know. How much do things need to go their way before I'm like, okay, they're actually properly ahead? Because I've got this bias in my head, which is like, because of the drop, they need to be like very far ahead for me to actually think they're ahead, because spirits are just looking so much more versatile and like, just the drop is just favorable, I think, if the game goes late.
Yeah, no, there's no question. And recently in the past few days, I've just seen a lot of these push strats, they have failed, they stall out, and then they end up losing. Like, they almost lost to that Ember Spirit earlier, like it was getting kind of close, you know. It just seems like there certainly is the possibility. It's not quite 6.83, but it's still feasible.
Yeah, I agree. I think that I mean, bottom line is that if you're the team doing the push strat, you're usually on a timer. You have to go high ground, and then yeah, these awkward high ground fights
either. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, is this a smoke coming? Yep, I'll pop that.
And is this for Rush? Or...
I don't think. I think they just want Zeus.
Well, Zeus is going to be theirs, but... Oh, maybe not.
Yeah, they missed the swap. There you go.
He tried to stun initially. Doesn't have as long range, but... Gonna make a kill anyway.
Okay, how short did level 1 nether swap used to be, honestly? Didn't it used to be like half that? Jeez, it was like 500 or something maybe?
It used to be, I think it used to be 550, and then they made it 600, then 625, then 700.
It was so short. Well, Ramses, he gets cogs under the tower, Thundergod's Wrath comes out, and the God Strength is gonna help finish off the Clockwork. Can't get the final one though. Onto Ivan, so it'll be a one for one.
Like, I'm pretty sure there was a stage where where level 3 was like 900, and now you can level 1 plus Aetherlands, and that's 900. Swap's a really good spell.
I just couldn't believe that swap. I was like, alright, that Witch Doctor's gonna go away, and then I was like, what? I was like, oh yeah, times have changed.
Yep. Well, remember, we had this discussion about the Aetherlands, and you favor the Oracle. That's your own business.
It's just because I'm right. I mean, oh, they double warded for that kill.
I think the Aetherlands is so good on Venge that I think core Vengers should consider it. And I don't know if that's ever going to happen. I haven't seen anyone do it yet, but like that's how good I think it is.
So does that mean you go like Arcane Boots into Aetherlands into TP?
Yeah. Which is, by the way, which is like, I actually think Arcane Boots in lane is really good for Venge. It's like,
oh yeah, can't deny that.
Having it in lane means that the offlane or whatever you're against just can't be in the lane anymore, because it's like permanent threats of kill with the unit supports, as opposed to like just one threat of kill or two. I don't know, it's just, this is a hero I've spammed at ranks in like mid 5k, and I usually play at supports. Occasionally my team's like, no, you must carry, and then I just buy the other lanes anyway. And but it works.
I just do it anyway, so I'll screen you guys. So it goes. Ivan? He's gonna swap out if he can not get chain stunned. Oh, silence. He's looking to turn this. Minus armor coming out. Ramses. Now, no stun for himself. Here comes the overgrowth. Thunder God's Wrath. Afterlife just has his pickings here. One shallow grave. And he's running up on this drow.
Where are you going?
He's disabling the aura here. And they get cogs inside, though, so he can't get the machine gun firing off, but we're gonna lose the Chen. And then it looks like Ivan will be next. One more right click. And running low on impetus mana here, but it should be okay. Goblack healing himself up with the leech. He's been doing a lot of the work this fight, but... And suddenly, I thought that was going to go the way HR, but they're all healed up. They're making the run back here. Just a couple more of these shallow... Ooh. Nice shadow wave. Nice fairy fire. Almost burned him down.
Yeah, Sven just wasn't in the right position. Like, Goblack got like a 4-person tree ulti, and they had Zeus ulti, and Sven didn't really get up many attacks off.
Yeah.
Sven got one or two attacks over the God Strength and the Cleave, could be very different. We had a very importantly timed Grave from Undershock as well, which I think probably decided the fight, actually, that Grave. That if it doesn't come off, then Venge goes down and team probably goes down together. But so far, so good for HellRaisers, actually, positioning themselves to...
I think that Cogs is pretty huge too, just keeping the Enchantress in line, because that was like free reign. They were on the run, and that's the last place you want to be up against Enchantress. She can just do her little dance back and forth. She sprunks at you.
I agree with that. I will point you to the fact that Goblack has purchased a point booster. Despite the fact that he hasn't only been farming, poor form as a carry, he's still getting farm. He's protecting his teammates, getting involved, but still getting his farm, and it's just one of many ingredients in the drone that make me feel like if it goes long enough, Team Spirit just like almost automatically win the game.
Yeah.
But the whole if it goes long enough is the question at the moment, and HellRaisers at the moment are saying no, it's not gonna go long enough, and they're doing all the right things, honestly. You gotta give them credit for that.
Yeah, but similarly is what you said before, I'm just not convinced. I think it's the best way to put it. The graph, it's helping me along, though. It's gonna be about 5,100 now in the lead here for HR. And the 12 minutes, definitely exactly what they're looking at here. They just can't stall out like last time. You have to imagine that two games in a row trying to draft this must be something that they are comfortable attempting, trying to do. And, well, they're up against, as we talk about, one of the favorites, Team Spirit. Solid squad, looking good lately.
There's not a lot of damage on Spirit yet, though. It's like, it's all Zeus, really. It's like, Sven can't get up to you and attack you without dying. Chandra's, okay, sure, she's got damage, but she's also pretty... I guess, yeah, they can't deal with her, so she's pretty good damage. Witch Doctor is not level 6 yet. Tree doesn't deal damage. Tree just, like, does things, not damage.
And you know what else they've done is that we saw that really really early Ancient Ward there, and that is something that... You know, a lot of Svens have been using lately to propel themselves. Specifically, they also use it in the last game here for Team Spirit. He just gets so insanely farmed that there's really no way they can deal with you. And it's a nice little comeback mechanism. Like, it's kind of like your pocket piggy bank here when you're getting squished in by a push to line up here. And it looks like they're going to try and find something here.
I think HR win a fight here, like, very definitely. If a fight happens, I think they win. If they've got Aegis, they've got mech, and there's just not enough damage on the dice side. Unless Zeus stays alive and gets past, like, billion spells throughout the fight, but even then, there's a Dazzle, there's a Chen, and Zeus is not staying alive.
An iceberg, no, it's not looking that way. Blade Mill coming up though, and it's gonna help finish him off. There's gonna be a buyback from Zeus, he's gonna TP back in. Hand of God comes out now. Here's that cleave that we're looking for. They're gonna get one to swap, gonna keep try and keep the Drow away from this. She's still graved up, still has the Aegis inside. Ramsey's trying to finish her off. He'll go down for it. And she's gonna be popping up at full HP. The impetus does stock down the Dazzle on the high ground. Now Shasha, he's the next to go with the end of this. Boom! And now Alpha Ninja, kapow! Sprunk. He's on a killing spree. And that ends up being a 1-for-4. I should say 1-for-2 for the buyback. But still, yeah. Big old win there. Angry pings coming out from the Drow.
Yeah, and that's what I was trying to. Zeus has the damage, maybe, to win the fight for them. If they burst on the Zeus, it's like, okay, we can't possibly lose the fight, but then he buys back, and it's not something you're usually playing around this early in the game, to be honest. You're like, when you're going high ground, you're playing around the buyback. When you're going tier 2, this early, I don't know, like, do we hold it against HR that they didn't anticipate the buyback? Was it more that they didn't react to it? Because I feel like maybe there's an opportunity to react to it and not. But they were very deep. They went very deep. And again, it's like, if you think Zeus is dead, you can go very deep. So the buyback is just everything in that fight, in my opinion.
I don't know, man. This Agnum Scepter. Where is it, Galblack? Come on now. I've been told stories.
Witch Doctor's got level 6 now, so, well, actually level 7, so that's another source of damage, potentially. Death Ward. Sven gets a couple items, and does a lot of damage too, because there's not necessarily that much control for him. Enchantress is pretty close to Aghanim's. I'm actually a bit surprised she didn't go for Dragonlance first.
Dragonlance, like, yeah.
Very cheap way to get there.
It's like a 900 gold stall, almost. Seems like it would make a lot of sense, just hold on to it. And then after you build your... Yeah, you can go like Dragonlance and then disassemble for the Agnum Scepter and then buy another Dragonlance, or Dragonlance. Keep saying Dragonlance. But... Not so lucky on this battle here. I don't know, I guess just not in the position to fight it.
But we'll let it go. This time Zeus doesn't have buyback. So
true.
They try to defend again, same thing happens, Zeus gets hooked and they just like all die or something. They'll be acutely aware of the fact that they won that fight because of the buyback. And it means they're still behind, but it's a very good stopgap. It's like, they just need to stall enough to get, you know, finish the Axe on the Tree, finish the Axe on the Enchantress, get something on Sven. Hopefully Zeus can get a 4-star, I think, as well, to not automatically die to clock. And HR are doing the right thing, recognizing, like, this is really, really good, actually. I was talking about in the previous series we were casting together how a lot of teams react a bit, you know, their psychology is affected too much by losing a fight. HR are like, no, we can do this. And
they gotta believe. SEA Dota coming out here from HR. That's the play, that's the plan. There's the swap. And it doesn't get capitalized on those. And now just Ivan's in the middle of nowhere. Hook comes in, not gonna be able to find the Zeus in the back. He's gonna find Sven in the front. Should be okay, the blade mail. And it's giving a little bit of damage back for now, with the Thunder God's Wrath. It'll be the 2-for-1 against Sven, he's the sacrificial pig. But the gods have accepted the sacrifice, it's now a 3-for-1. Again, Undershock, man, he loves these TPs out. And they can't catch him.
Yeah, just as what Caster's Curse, I'm praising their confidence and they get overconfidence. Because I think that they are fully in their rights to be pushing there. I think it's even okay to think, let's target Zeus. But you've got to be in a position where, like, if you're making that swap on Zeus, Zeus is dying straight away. Clock's gonna hook straight away, you're gonna just burst on Zeus, and that's not what happens. Like, they're definitely thinking. They're thinking, we don't lose the fight if Zeus dies without casting any spells. But it doesn't happen at all. They swapped Zeus in, Venge died without casting any more spells, not Zeus.
Yeah, there was absolutely no follow-up to that swap, and it was just way too deep. Like, so far into the base. I feel like you at least need the tier 3 tower down before you go for that play.
Like, okay, fine, credit to them, they still kill the Sven. Sven is meant to be the main carry, the main damage source, and Sven is still very behind on farm. But Tree is now getting close to Axe, and Charles has Axe. Zeus is really close to war stuff, and I give them one more. Like, honestly, HR, like, mess up one more fight. And
that's it?
That's maybe it.
And Ramses is so ready for a fight, he just bought another mango. He's good to go. He's gonna have one delivered to him, just in case. Oh, did he actually just sell it? He sold it. He bought a mango and sold it. How dare he? Mm. Alright, well, you may be correct here. This definitely looks like a smoke gathering group here. So they're gonna go for it. All out aggression, attack. Never let it fail. Radiant Vision, they do see the Zooks, they see Ramses. They're pinging him out. And he's the man they want. They're smoking past his observer back here. And we'll switch the all vision. Alright, there's the eyes. Again, a little bit of miscommunication, but they'll still get the kill. And that does mean there's no follow-up kill, unfortunately. Despite their vision, they could have turned that right onto Ramses too.
Sven's water blinks actually. Well, Sven's water blinks. The plan here is Tree's been getting off these nice ultis. And I think the plan is Sven can just blink into the middle and try to get some cleaver.
Yeah.
And that's the axe.
Look what it is.
He sold his iron talent for it.
Sub 20 minutes. We got this, baby.
The last time he had it with the iron talent, though. So you can see he's under pressure.
Alright, well, there's no Aegis this time. So they gotta be watching out here. Goblack, he does turn invis under the ward. Oh, actually, he didn't. I don't think they saw that. In fact, I'm quite certain they didn't. In fact, he's pinging out the ward, so it's like they have
no
idea.
For Zeus.
Let's get the mind games.
Zeus is alive now, and that's.
That's it.
Zeus is. Pick Rush. Rush is not up yet.
And I feel like this definitely benefits Team Spirit in a sense, just because now the Aghanim Scepter's up. So this next push, like. I wonder if he can hide it. Or I wonder if they know. Oh, they're just gonna smoke right into them. Oh no! Afterlife! He attacks the creeper! Oh, Goddamn just walks right into them! What?
That's,
Microfail. Oh no, now he's the buyback. Yeah, it definitely was Microfail. Now there's Cogs. He's in the middle of three, so he's gonna split the fight up, but no one's really doing anything. Ramsey, he's chasing after Ninja. Maybe it is gonna work out. Iceberg gets off the ultimate. No damage done thanks to the Glimmer Cape. Just gonna be revealing. They're gonna lose the Cockwork back where he was. Big Impetus. 2 more seconds. Get the blink if he wants to go for this. Wants to track him down. Impetus again. Just gonna stun him.
Oh, Drow's back.
Alright, here we go. There's the Zeus though. Drow back. Clockwork Venge. Still the only ones down here. Goddamn, maybe one to follow. Dust popped out. Tired of this invis. Another buyback here from the Clockwork. Trying to chase down the Chen. Goddamn, under the tower. They're duking it out. And armor is too strong. The flare. Not affected by armor, however. Goblack now stuck under the tower. He doesn't make it the sense. He's got a magic wand, but he's gonna be 8 charges. Won't pop it. And it ends up being a. Well, I guess we'll find out all these buybacks. There were a couple. 2 buybacks, so 4 for 3. Still going in the favor of Team Spirit with all that gold difference.
Yeah, and again, the one very big cost for Spirit, though, is that Sven didn't get the gold. Sven ended up dying. Sven has just died every single time. And yeah. Look how far down he is in the net worth. And this is the hero that I feel like completes the. Like, if Sven gets BKB. Like, just whatever next item is, it's probably BKB, right? If Sven gets BKB, that's where the game turns.
I guess it probably has to be BKB at this point. He's getting pretty controlled here. I don't know if he wants to try something. Maybe... well, Ryu and I were talking last game about how it used to be like almost like you had to make a decision between Mask of Madness or Helm of the Dominator. And you really wanted the Mask of Madness, but you're afraid you'd die. With you know, all this control from Goblack and everything like that, is there the possibility that he just goes for the YOLO play? I mean, I don't think they really need the YOLO play, but I feel like the way HR have to play, they could walk right into a Mask of Madness game ender.
That's true, but I don't think Spirit have to take the risk. So I don't think
that's the thing,
fact,
yeah.
It's more likely to me that they buy... You know, if you buy Helm of Dominator, then you can still steal Chen creeps, can't you?
Yep.
And then Enchantress can steal another, so you like just run in and take 2 creeps to start the fight. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's definitely the more common pickup these days, like by far. I know, I haven't seen a Mask of Madness in a while.
But in this game, I would say just he's going to leave it Morbid Mask, and he's just going to go straight BKB.
Yeah, seems good to me. A couple of things that will be piercing that, but you got to watch out for all those Chen creeps and everything else. And now, they're on to the big creep, the big man. Big boss, big cheese, well no cheese yet, but Upshot coming outside the pit. They've got the vision up there, provided from the dire side, and that was, I'm not sure, I guess that was just a flare vision.
I really like that Undershock's walking around with a gem and a quelling blade, just neutralizing the Aghanim Scepter effect from Goblack. Very important to do this actually, you can't just be walking into those trees all the time, and I've just watched him walk around, he's eaten like 3 or 4 in a row. I actually still think it's the same position I described before. The HR like can't afford, they can't like throw this fight. They get wiped. Even if they kill like two or three heroes, it's like very big trouble for them.
I can't tell if it's my own bias. I still I know what you're saying, like I still don't feel like they've ever been that, like I don't feel like Team Spirit's in the realm of losing, you know what I mean? Like I don't feel like they've lost or anything. I don't even feel like they're that behind. It's just like a difference of strategies right now. Is that kind of how you feel? I feel like it must be my own bias coming to play because they are pretty far behind when it comes to gold experience.
No, they're behind, especially because the Sven doesn't have much. Sven is going to be grabbed, pulled out. Draw's the one in danger now. She's got edges, but doesn't have HP there. This is really bad. Really bad for HR.
Like, I just don't see how they actually achieve their goal here. Anyway, Silence comes out, stun. They're gonna drop Ivan. Now half a ninja. He's gonna be losing his agency here. Goddamn, he's nearby. But like, what can they do? They're just gonna ignore half a ninja. He gets glimmered up there. Well, they'll go down now. Pick off Goddamn. Go back to the Aegis. I'm gonna try this out here. That would be like the most greatest escape of all time. Swap back. They want to go for the Dazzle here, and they are gonna find him. And it's gonna be five heroes. Well.
In the gym, so the tree can ulti and Dazzle can fight. Like, okay, now spirits are winning. Like, doesn't matter what the discussion was before the fight, it's like, without any doubts in my mind, spirits are like comfortably ahead in the game now.
Apparently, something decided to happen there where it got muted on the stream. So many fun days today.
Got muted.
Just me, don't worry.
Just you.
Just me.
So it's
even more exciting. No, no, we're... no, we're all good. Now. But apparently for the past 5 minutes, my talks weren't going into the stream. Man, so many blunders today. I'm having some issues. It's mostly because of all these stupid hotfixes I have to make due to men breaking apart my home.
Would you say you're on tilt?
I'm more on tilt than... probably HR right now.
Well, that's because HR been doing a good job of not tilting. And I love this. So Vengeful Spirit did not go for the Etherlands like I suggested, but did go for the Aghanim Scepter, which is also pretty rare on the core Vengeful Spirit. But it's that extra, you know, short cooldown on swap. It's obviously you can respawn when you die briefly. And you can swap creeps every now and then, if that matters.
Alright, well, they're gonna swap him out, the Enchantress, bringing him in, Stormhammer coming up onto Ivan, brought back with the Grave, Shoshlo, in a little bit of trouble here, cast, bouncing around. Iceberg, he'll go down, alright, they got the Zeus, he's got the buyback, can he save it again, or will he even have to? Shoshlo, though, Lightmail hasn't been able to do too much this game, now it seems to be working out. Afterlife's still gonna get the kill, Ramses on the back end, he'll grab that. There's the buyback from Gobleck, Impetus tearing through this Drow. Couple more here, Leech Seed, Undershock, again, the last one remaining, Ramsey's looking forward.
Oh, they lost.
And got him.
I mean, I don't want to be that commentator, but they lost. It's actually an omelet on Sven. Not even feeling the pressure to straight to the BKB because of how the game turned around. It's like the players can clearly sense they've turned that corner and... like, the major threats of them in the game is gone. I mean, honestly, it's Spirits. I sort of feel like the early game in this game, they were a bit sloppy. They allowed HR to assemble the way they wanted to. They gave them momentum they wanted. And maybe deserved to actually lose the game. But they've done enough to punish HR's mistakes as the game extended. And looking more and more like it's going to be a 2-0.
Well, I'm just gonna constantly look over my production buttons here. Make sure I don't mute myself again. You know what I it's because I typed a shout out to Lizard and I muted myself with the hotkeys because they don't deactivate when you close the window. Sorry guys.
That's okay, despicable.
It is pretty despicable.
You know,
that's what happens, man. You know, I run my own stream, I don't have a single production issue for like 3 days, and I hop on here and it's blunders left, right, and center. I'm just not a professional esporter yet.
Are you blaming Minduck?
I could. I just need Pimp, you know? That's what it is.
Dazzle's been quartz. And he's got the grave. Let's use the glimmer cape.
Living. Oh! Nice cogs. Save them. That ultimate is coming right out.
With the old cogs have saved there, because you know we were talking about the difference between the circular and the.
I don't think they would have.
Yeah, it's. So, situationally, there's definitely advantages of the new cogs sometimes.
I could agree with that. I think it probably is actually better in the later game stages, assuming one can get used to it.
What are these creeps doing?
What? In the other game, not as much. I don't know, they were just sitting there. I just went past them.
Then just, like, had some creeps.
And now he's got control clicking micros.
A tomato and a meat wagon. They're not actually called meat wagons. So you don't even know what I'm talking about, do you? That's
no. Is that what they were called in Dota 1?
they were called meat wagons.
Why were they called meat wagons?
Only the dire siege creep, because it came from Warcraft 3,
right.
And the Warcraft 3, the creeper was modeled on is from like the scourge or whatever. What are they called even? The undead. So obviously the undead siege engine is a meat wagon because. Carrying around like corpses and it throws them at people. I don't even remember what the Radiant one was called. But actually, it wasn't called Radiant and Diabetic, it was called Sentinel and Scourge. And the Sentinel had like this glaive thrower or something.
Sentinel and the Scourge. Alright, I'm back in Dota TV if I was muted. Or back in the stream if I was muted. Huh. So it's good.
It's kind of weird to think. There's so many people in the world who watched who don't know what I mean when I say meat wagon. That's a strange thought.
Yeah, well, that's life now, Scant. You know, you're an old man.
Yeah.
And I was feeling a little bit old. What were we talking about earlier? It was something I was talking about with Ryu. This is a very bad story when I can't remember it. Either way, they're gonna find another shock, and we'll just skip past this, my shitty story. Stormhammer comes through, can't get a grave off in time to waste a little bit of time. And they say nay.
What was he doing there?
I don't know.
Was he trying to ward? Was he trying to, like, put up a sneaky ward or...? That's like, now, you know, it's the first few fights that HR lost, he was the last one to go down, and now since then, we just see him getting caught in, like, strange places on his own on the map. So, maybe just over it. He's like, you know, I'm the 5 position support, and I've been doing everything to keep you guys alive, and you're just like, you're ungrateful. And now he's gonna, like, cut off his nose to...
They really are tilting. They've completely lost it. And... Speaking of tilting, they have, like, no way of finding out all these trees either. This game gets so hard, it's 50 more seconds before they can have their gem back.
Is that BKB on Sven? I don't know. I don't know, what do HellRaisers have to do to win this game?
Have the Team Spirit disconnect? Classic. Mm-hmm. Never gets old. But seriously? I don't know, you have a core of Venge, like...
What?
Can you really rat it out?
Okay, I have a very serious and important question to ask.
Okay.
Vengeful Spirit bought an Aghanim Scepter. Where is it?
Did she? Did she sell and buy a DKB?
She legit had a Scepter in the previous fight.
Alright, well, I guess he decided he can't die. Now that Death Ward bouncing around. Doing its thing. Oh, that impetus! The max damage. And nice, gonna be close to grabbing this last kill. A little right click coming up from Ramsey. Oh, or just an urn. Oh, Shadow Grave might keep him up and alive. Ramsey's trying to right click him down. They do have the vision. And they can't get him. He's just being a drow. Okay. Overextension from Afterlife. Okay, is this the finisher? Oh,
yeah.
Got him.
They've given up. I mean, Dazzle's been walking around feeding, but Vengeful Spirit bought an Aghanim Scepter and then sold it. That's like a 4,000 gold investment. You just give up half the gold, like. Oh, you know what? I went to BKB actually. Like, no. This is like, I'm not even sure. HR, I think they're staying in the game right now. Out of like, they're arguing with each other on TeamSpeak.
Is it because Afterlife enchanted it? Because you can do that.
I didn't see that happen. Maybe that's why. I don't know.
You can steal it.
That's... I don't know. It's just, it feels like every sign of HR, like staying in the game just because, like, ugh, why not? But I don't think anyone in the team right now...
She stole the enchant, or the illusion during that team fight. That's brutal, because then it lasts for the entire time until she respawns.
Oh, I see. Okay, that's ridiculous. Somehow we missed that. We're terrible, but...
Man, that's why chat's here, man. They're like,
I'm pretty sure
the
first fight's Avenger the Axe. I'm pretty sure Enchantress did not take it, because I was watching the Venge Spirit there. So it must have been the second one that it happened. Which is funny, because in the first one, the Venge Ghost was actually fighting the Enchantress.
Yeah, it was like actually in the base.
Yeah. Zeus has got an Octarine Core. Which is not what I'm used to seeing as the build-up. Netherlands, forced off Octarine Core. I'm much more used to seeing Bloodstone, Aghanim's Refresher, those kind of items. But this is actually very high damage output between the Netherlands and the Octarine. Just like that much more permanent spam damage. And this is the play HR, like, let's try get rush. That's our last hope.
Alright, the hookshot comes through. They do connect onto the Witch Doctor. They've got the Roshan. It's still on the ground. Venge will pick it up. Death Ward coming out. Going to be finishing off shots still here. Blade Mill not doing anything to the Witch Doctor, of course. He's going to buy back on the Clockwork. Impetus coming through. Going to first blow up the Chen. Ivan next on the list, but he'll get graved up. So instead, he'll go for the backline. Hanging to Appa Ninja. Has the cheese. Gets it off just in time. But you know what? Nah, what's the big deal? It's just a couple more of a chance. Impetus, spring.
As usual, Undershock right at the end.
Yeah, he goes and hides. Waiting for a good grave opportunity. Might find it here on Ivan. If he can reach past his own allies' cogs, which he can't. Okay, the weave. Ivan, living. Dead. Shoshlo. Look at that. They're even pinging him.
Whatever, we've killed that guy now. Let him TP off.
Alright.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
I think it might be over.
Yeah, this I don't know what the play is. I don't know what the like is. It's
fall. Look at all these red leaves across the map.
You know, that's like a North American thing, right?
Oh.
But actually, it might be European as well, but definitely in South Africa, nobody says fall. I don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Autumn.
That's...
Oh, yeah, it's autumn. Mm.
Anyway, isn't there like a film called Autumn in New York, which is like an American film starring someone?
I mean, we say autumn, but everyone calls it fall.
Is it literally just because like leaves fall? Is that what it's named after?
Yeah. So we're very like, simple people.
Like, why don't you call summer hot? Like, I don't know. I just think it. And things fall in winter as well. Rain falls, and snow falls.
Here I have a South African bugging me about cultural issues. Okay, well, we'll see. We'll see about that. Either way, we're.
Oh, that's a fair point.
Got the enchant. Living.
You know what? White South Africans have a lot to account for. I take that. I accept that.
Alright. Yeah, where are
you? Goblock has two void stones. So he's going for a refresh, I guess. Just looks funny with the two void stones like that. Yeah, he could have had a perseverance, but
for all these
he wants
trees. More trees. He's Johnny Appleseed. Alright, is it happening? Is it over? Do you believe in the end of the game actually occurring?
I think the play here is for Chen to send Venge back and then Venge swap someone in. That's the play. And as you know, drop someone
good.
In. It's pretty decent actually. It's quite an old school play.
What if they showed off a new bug where if you did the perfect timing, they wound up in Fountain where the Venge is supposed to be? And then this happens in our game and they come back and win, like TI. Wouldn't that be incredible?
That would
be
incredible.
It's like the same scenario.
Looks like Chen does not believe in the strat though.
It hasn't happened yet. Ramses, he's in the base. Swapped out, into the shallow grave, up clockwork, looks like it'll still go down to the Zeus. And it's already over. Ramses jumps in, he kills some people. Alpha Ninja can just helplessly be sprung from the back lines. His afterlife shakes it off with but a giggle and a laugh. Much as everyone knows to be the most annoying thing about Enchantress.
HR have some reflection to do. I mean, I don't know, this has been 2-0 losses to them. I think every team has 4 games, right? 4 matches, so I guess theoretically they could still get 4 points. But they're on the edge, they're on the brink of elimination. I think actually, I'm not sure the score in the other series, Na'Vi versus this is Mama's Boys, but I think Mama's Boys are also on the brink, which means that this group becomes very, very exciting because two teams go through to the playoffs from each group, and it looks
right.
I